I think that it's, no, I guess where I'm going is I'm thinking about how wonderful this is, this experience. And what I think about is the before and the after, the non-physical.
What we think about is the what's coming. What we think about is the now and what's coming, the now and what's coming.
So
because
where I am,
because there's no regression, and anything we look back toward is less than that which we have come to. So it is a less momentum frequency, and therefore an introduction of resistance into the moment. Do you get that? There's no going back.
So not regression in the back sense, but when we choose to come forth, the gifts that we have in the physical state to accomplish the things that we're here to do.
What are those gifts?
I guess that's part of what I'm, that's been the fun part of alignment.
The ability to observe, the ability to perceive, and the ability to feel emotion. Those are the gifts that you were born with to help you mold the energy which the clay of this time-space reality is the thought energy.
So as that awareness has come in and as those things have happened and the alignment starts to hit and everything starts to flow, that's part of the purpose. That is the purpose. And then the individual gifts that we've each been given to be able to share with others or teach others or move on within and expand, that's part of that. Is that the reason for it? And then my second
the reason for it is the reason for it is for the in the moment joyous experience of being. That's the reason for it. It's for the joy. It's for the love. It's for the fun. It's for the clarity. It's for the alignment. It's for the feeling of it. That's the reason for it. The basis of everything is freedom. You are so free you can choose bondage. The result of it is expansion. But the reason for it is for the joy of it, for the exhilaration of it. And that's what we were attempting to say to you, is that humans want us, when we say freedom, growth, and joy, and they'll say, yes, growth, growth, growth. We say, yes, of course. Growth is the result, of course. But the reason, the, what it is all about, is for the joyful experience. That's really what we are all in all of this for, because we can't cease to be. The expansion is inevitable. Mm-hmm. So if you get your sights on the way you feel and you let that be the dominant thing that you care about, then the inevitable expansion is going to take place, but you've satisfied your reason for being. Mm-hmm. Think about it. As creative geniuses, who you are before you come into this physical body, why would you come into a place where there is the possibility of losing your connection on your high-flying disc? Well, the reason that you're willing to do it is because you know that you're going to parlay something else forward. You know that you're going to cause expansion. And so this is a triad of intentions that are pretty much equal in importance. And when you understand all of them, I'm free to choose thoughts that feel good or thoughts that don't feel good. And expansion is the is inevitable no matter what I choose, but I can have a joyful moment during this expansion or a less than joyful moment in this expansion. I think I choose joyful moment in this expansion. This is what we've been talking about here today. We know that a lot of you have been listening to us for a while, some of you for a long while, and a lot of you have been reading what we've been writing and applying the processes that we've been offering. And today, It really is like pushing a reset button, because today you understand things that you didn't understand so clearly before. And we think that you have accomplished, from your personal point of view, that you want to say, I have discovered a simplicity to it that I did not know before. A simplicity to how this all works that I did not really know before. That really has been our intention in these hours that we've been talking, is that we want you to feel the simplicity of it. It's such an easy thing to awaken, refreshed, and stay there for a while. It's such an easy thing to practice good feeling thoughts and acknowledge which thoughts feel good and which thoughts don't, and then becoming more discriminating. Such an easy thing. We don't see you at the buffet, at the restaurant, putting something nasty in your mouth and then just going back for it again and again and again. We see you discriminating on what kind of an experience that you're having with it. And so that's all that we're asking for you to do here, is be discriminating about how it feels. And what you're getting at is that your ability to discriminate becomes more and more refined and therefore more and more satisfying. When you're discriminating among faster moving energy, it is ultimately more satisfying than when you're discriminating among slower moving energy. But you can't jump from negative emotion to positive emotion. You can only jump to negative emotion, to something that's less negative, to something that's less negative, to something that's less negative, unless you do it the first thing in the morning. This is the simplicity that we are bringing to you. In other words, there are hard ways of going about this, and there are easy ways of going about this. The easy way of going about this is to just accept that you are a worthy being. But you're not ready to do that because you've been practicing other thoughts that don't allow you to do that. So we're sort of showing you how to come in the back door of finding that feeling that feels good, and then just milking it for a little while until you're stable in that emotion, and then watch what comes from that. When we say you are the deliberate creator of your experience, you have often thought that what we mean by that is that you will sit and think powerful thoughts chronically, steadily, that you, in other words, you take your same action-oriented work ethic to thinking that you've been applying to action. But we're wanting you to understand that with thought, it's different. With thought, you're reaching for ease. With thought, you're reaching for the ease of thought. You're reaching for ease in thought. Because it's only when you are feeling ease in thought that you're actually vibrationally up to speed with the object of your desire. So if you find yourself struggling or trying, what you want to stop and do, what you want to do is stop and say, I'm efforting here. I think I'll just let this subject aside for a little bit while I focus upon something that I can do something about. If we were standing in your physical shoes, we would go through our day with this powerful intention. I'm on my way to work, and I'm going to enjoy the transfer there as much as I possibly can. I'm about to have lunch. I'm going to choose the best feeling thing that I can think of, and I'm going to eat it in the most delightful space that I have available to me. And if you just keep reaching for that, some of you are worried that your employers won't like it, or you think that there are things that you need to do that you must do. Esther said to us a few weeks ago, in a rather pronounced statement of forcefulness, Abraham, I know you want me to be on my high-flying disc and then, but there are things I need to do today whether I'm on my high-flying disc or not. And that's what we want all of you to get over. We don't want you to any longer make excuses about why you're not on your high-flying disc. We want that to be your dominant intention. Do you accept the existence of it? Do you understand that it's a vibrational state of being? Do you understand that the thoughts that you present are what equal where you are in relationship to it? Do you understand that your emotions will guide you there? You understand that momentum, that when you get on a high-flying disc and you become more specific, that the momentum will really please you? Do you understand that when you're on a low-flying disc and you become more specific, that the momentum will not please you? Do you think that your emotions are active enough within you that you can tell whether you want to pursue something or not? Do you think that you have the self-discipline to draw back from something that has momentum that is taking you to where you do not want to go? Do you think that you have the patience to reach for this high-flying disc? Do you think that you're willing to give it a week or two or three to see what happens? Are you expectant of positive results to come back to you? Do you believe that what you think and feel and what manifests are always the same? Are you looking forward to the revelations, the manifestations, the demonstrations of your improved thought? Are you willing to pronounce success no matter where you stand relative to anything? Are you willing to acknowledge that the universe is delivering to you lovingly exactly what you are presenting vibrationally? Are you willing to acknowledge that you can choose what you're presenting vibrationally, and what comes back will reflect that change? Do you understand what a paradigm shift is? Do you understand that you have a point of attraction that you can effectively change? Is it logical to you that in these hours that we've been together, we've been relentless about this subject, to the point that you're almost wondering if there's anything else that we ever want to say to you? And the answer to that, there's hardly anything ever that we ever want to say to you more than get on your high-flying disc. And then, are you willing to acknowledge that just being in a conversation that has gone on this long has reset your vibrational placement in the universe? It's like you've reset your button and you have a new point of attraction. Are you expecting things to be different today? Yes. And this is the thing that we really want you to hear. Just like Luke pushed his reset button that day and had quite a day at the fair, and Kate pushed hers and had quite a day at the fair. In other words, you, whatever button you push is what the universe is going to bring back to you, but it only lasts as long as today. That's the most important thing that we want to say to you. Every day, you're wanting to push that button again. Every day, you're wanting to get on that high-flying disc again. The momentum that is coming to you is coming in response to what you've got going on now. This is a really interesting thing to put this late in the seminar, sort of ambushing you with this important thought. But we really want, as far as you've come and with what we can feel that you now know, we think this is a really important place to leave this gathering today. We want you to understand that every day is a new day, and that the momentum that you establish today equals your point of attraction today. And tomorrow, what you establish will equal your point of attraction tomorrow. So all that you're really carrying over from day to day is the propensity. The most important thing that we could ever accomplish with those like you who we care about so much is convincing you that tomorrow morning you have the ability to get on the disc or not, and everything in that day will be in response to the choices that you made early on. And if you can accept that, then you're going to deliberately and consciously live happily ever after. We have enjoyed this interaction, and words do not do justice to the party that we have as we feel the logic and alignment that takes place within you. We are happy to meet you on your intellectual level, where we find resonance with that which you truly are. It's important for you to know that you are the creator of your own reality, but it's also important for you to know that you have teams, throngs of non-physical assistants that you have not been accessing in your attitude of, I need to go this alone. We want you to understand that not only do you not need to go it alone, it's not possible for you to go it alone, but it is possible for you to choose discs where your help isn't, and then have a harder journey on your way to where you don't want to go. Whereas you put all of this together and you acknowledge that the path is an easy one, and that it's well lighted, and that if you do just this simple work that we've been talking about so that the path does light up, then not only will it be a path of ease, but it will be a path of chronic happiness. And then you'll feel like that invincible being where it feels like you're waving this magic wand and anything you point at will open for you. And those who are standing back watching you, who have not been privy to the vibrational exchange, who don't know that law of attraction is managing the universe, and who do not understand that they are emitting a vibration that is being responded to, they will watch you in amazement, and they will call you things like lucky. They will call you things like fortunate. They will marvel at the good fortune that comes to you. But they will not understand that you are now the deliberate creator of your experience. And it's not magic. It's cashing in the vibrational currency that you've always had access to. We don't even need to tell you to spend it wisely, because it never stops flowing. Spend it with fun and with eagerness and often. There is great love here for you.